Hi, my name is Sabrina Barreiro from CableOrganizer.com, and I'm here with my coworker Matthew Carville. I would like to answer some questions from our customer. What's the difference between Cat5, Cat5e, and Cat6 cables?
Well, Cat5 is the most basic. It was the first of those three standards that was produced. It comes in two types, solid, which is more rigid and more appropriate for long distance cabling, and stranded, which is more flexible and more appropriate for patching situations. It has a capability of up to 100 megahertz, and has a transition speed rated for either 10 megabits or 100 megabits per second over Ethernet. Cat5e, where the E stands for enhanced, is a more enhanced version of the Cat5 standard. It has basically replaced Cat5 in all new installations. It can handle up to 1,000 megabits per second over Ethernet, and it's got some improvements that have reduced the near-end crosstalk and other types of interference that make it better performing than the Cat5 standard. Finally, there's the Cat6 standard, which has improvements such as a longitudinal separator that further reduces crosswalk and in types of interference. It can support up to a 10 gigabit Ethernet transmission speed and has a capability of 250 megahertz. It's also backward compatible with both Cat5 and Cat5e installations.
Okay, so why would anyone choose one over the other one?
Well, the main difference is really a trade-off between cost versus performance. You won't really find Cat5 in any sort of new installation, so the choice is really between Cat5e and Cat6. Cat5e will probably be the better choice in situations where performance is not as important due to its reduced cost compared to Cat6. But in situations where you care more about getting the maximum possible speed, you probably want to choose Cat6 cable.
Okay, so what is your recommendation for a new network or a home network?
Well, in the case of a home network, you may be best off going with the Cat5e, where the speed and performance improvements in Cat6 probably won't be as important, and you may be more concerned about the cost. For situations where you're dealing with business applications where performance might be more of a factor, I would suggest going with the Cat6 cabling for the induced performance for the cost.
Thank you, Matthew. Thank you for watching our video, and if you have any other questions, you can call us at 866-222-0030. Thank you.